In this lesson, we are going to learn how to create a bar chart with lower and upper bounds. As you maybe know, bar and column charts are very useful when it comes to comparison. In this worksheet, we have the sales of these three products. Also, we have two more columns, lower limit and upper limit, a target that's been set by the company, for example. We want to compare the sales of a product with some lower and upper boundary, defined by some criteria. So, let's get started. Select the data and insert a clustered column chart. Switch row to column. So we have this chart with three columns. The blue column is sales, the orange is the upper limit, and the columns with a gray color is the lower limit. We want the sales to remain and the lower and upper bounds to be shown as markers and not columns. To do that, only right-click on either one of them and choose Change Series Chart Type. From this dialog box, we can easily change the chart type. Select Line with Markers for the lower and upper limits. Press OK. We don't want any connecting line for the upper and lower boundaries. So let's select the upper limit line. Right-click, Format Data Series, Fill and Line Bucket, and click No Line. Do the same for the lower limit line. So, we have a lower and upper boundary indicated by dots. It's better to change the market style. From the Format Data Series dialog box, there are some built-in markers, but I would prefer to use custom steps. The first step is to insert a down and up arrow. From Insert tab, Illustrations and Shapes. And place it somewhere here. Change the color to green and red. Let's resize them to be reasonably small. Now copy the down arrow and paste to the upper limit shape, then copy the up arrow and paste it to the lower limit shape. With this trick, you can instantly change the marker symbol to anything you want. Our chart is ready.